Joe Tessitore and Teddy Atlas ringside to call our main event. The tail of the tape, the most conspicuous you will see, is the height differential. 8 inches favoring Mario Barrios, 6'1 to 5'5. But how it manifests itself in productivity, maybe just as effective defensively as offensively for Barrios. According to CompuBox, he limits his opponents to 32 punches thrown per round and doubles the connects per round over his opponents. For the introductions, here is Sweet Baby Ray Flores.
Ladies and gentlemen, from the Sun National Bank Center here in Trenton, New Jersey, Premier Boxing Champions now features the main event. 12 rounds in the junior lightweight division. The three judges ringside are Case in Cheeks, Eugene Grant, and Joe Pasquale. And the referee in charge, when the bell sounds, Alan Huggins. Introducing first, fighting out of the red corner, wearing the black with the gold and the white trim. His professional record, an impressive one. 39 wins, 21 of those coming by way of knockout against 4 losses and 1 draw. Fighting out of Corazon, Italy. Ladies and gentlemen, signori, signori, Devis Boom Boom Boschiero. And across the ring, his opponent fighting out of the blue corner. He comes in wearing the red with the gold trim. As a professional, he is perfect. 15 wins, 8 of those coming by way of KO. Fighting out of San Antonio, Texas. Ladies and gentlemen, damas y caballeros, Mario El Niño de Oro Barrios.
Undefeated prospect from San Antonio, Texas, who many think
both have your instructions. Obey my command, protect yourselves at all times. It's a little bit high, everything above here is good. Touch them up. Okay, back to your corners.
Alan Huggins, our referee. This is a title eliminator for ranking in a sanctioning body at 130 pounds. The tall Texan, 6'1", 130-pound, undefeated Mario Barrios. Those in his camp having him with the moniker of the Golden Boy. A lot of hype. Will he deliver on it tonight?
Boschiero can come forward when he can. Crouch up a little bit. Put those hands up. Get into that peekaboo in here. He'll bend. As I said, he'll crouch. He'll do everything to get low. Try to get inside past that longer reach of Barrios. Sometimes he'll lean forward a little bit. The uppercut could be a weapon when he does that for Barrios. Barrios needs to use that jab, but you smart boxing fans out there don't need me to tell you that. Just look at the size difference of Barrios. If he doesn't use the jab in this fight, he'll never use the jab.
A downhill jab in this fight.
Can you see in all the experience of Boschiero? Boschiero fought for a world title, 2011, lost a split decision. Joe, Boschiero's 4 career losses, 2 were by split decision. Most of the fights in Italy, first time fighting in the U.S., has never lost in Italy, 40-0.
Yep.
His 44 losses in Japan, London, and France.
Fought for a title in Japan and lost a somewhat controversial split decision. That was back in 2011.
But he is 34 years old. And 3 fights ago, Boschiero was stopped by body shots. But Barrios and his people did their homework somewhere along the line. Obviously not in the first round. Somewhere along the line, they're gonna jab. and they're going to try to go to that body of Boschiero's.
The fight you reference for Boschiero was in September of 2015 against Stephen Smith, when he was stopped in six. Another eliminator fight to try to work his way up the rankings. He bounced back with two wins, and now Boschiero making his U.S. debut. A lackluster offensive showing from the Italian here in round number one. And the crowd lets him know it. Remember, you can go to the ESPN Boxing Facebook page to join in the scoring. Surely a round in favor of the undefeated Texan, the 21-year-old Mario Barrios. Now, Teddy and Saul with the fight plan.
Well, for Barrios, he's the taller guy. You don't need me to tell you, but I'll tell you anyway. He's not doing it, but against a short guy here, he's got to use that jab, control distance. Maybe if he gets him to reach in a little bit, bang, he can counter with left hooks. But for me, and you're going to see more of it, I'm going to point it out, but this man, Boschiero, well, the elbows go up a little bit when he covers up because of that peekaboo. He exposes all this. So get him to expose that. So if I'm in the corner of Barrios, I'm going to throw the 1-2, bang, bang, get him to do that and watch. Bang, bang, slip your head over here. Ah, nice little hole right there. Bang, right to the body. Little water in the basement, a flood in the basement. Got to start doing sit-ups there, kid.
Teddy, let me tell you something. Based on what I saw Saul do damage at Teddy and Lana's wedding in the cocktail reception yesterday, yeah, with the hors d'oeuvres, that basement was flooded last night. Trust me. Between the sushi bar, the prosciutto being hand-sliced, the pasta station, he did enough damage. Trust me.
There's stuff in that basement.
That basement is overflowing.
That basement's full.
Round two here of our main event, PBC on ESPN, coming to you from Trenton, New Jersey. Barrios, the taller fighter. Boschiero giving up 8 inches in height. Let's check in with Bernardo, who is in the corner of Barrios.
You know, Bob Santos said, I want you to keep working, open things up with a jab, and more importantly, don't worry about the crowd.
The crowd wants action. There was very little in that first round.
I'm tempted to make that first round a 10-9 out for the 10-9 for the ref.
Yeah, 10-9. The ref was the most active in that first round.
God. But to the fight plan, to the point of the fight plan, ladies and gentlemen out there, stay with us, stay with us. It's going to get interesting. Believe me, because Boschiero does come forward. He is a veteran, but in there with a much better opposition. And if he starts to think that Barrios is not the real thing, they get played. And I don't mean that in a demeaning way, that that's what it'd take to get brave, but he's smart enough to get brave, experienced enough to get brave. He'll say, hey, this guy's not what they say he is. I can use my experience, and maybe I can get a nice win against a guy that's not as good as his 15-0 record. And that's what he's gonna try to do, try to come forward now. And what's gonna happen, Barrios gonna nail him a counter shot, or Boschiero's gonna get close and maybe have some fun. As I said, obviously Boschiero jumping in with the much better opposition, proving he can fight at a higher level.
He got to the inside through a left hand, and it created an opportunity for Barrios. And now he tries to dig in with a body shot. Barrios comes back, opens up, created an opening for Boschiero to put something in there.
Told you it would get more interesting. We don't lie over here. And as I said, you know, Boschiero, he's been in with a much better opposition for a world title. He knows he can fight at that level. Barrios hasn't discovered that yet. That's what this fight is about. What level is Barrios at?
Testing themselves against veterans. And that'll happen again next week in our main event of the PBC on ESPN, as is the case here with Boschiero against the unbeaten Barrios. Copy box numbers there, Teddy. You see the punches thrown. Total punches 102 to 11 advantage for Barrios.
Yeah, who needs computers? You just need your fingers and one toe.
That's it. That's all you need.
No, really. I mean, you don't
fingers
need
and one toe. You're good at it.
You don't need the computer and keyboard.
No abacus necessary.
No, not at all. But, I mean, besides being undefeated, he never learned how to lose. Barrios, obviously. But the disadvantage he has in this fight is if it does get into the deeper waters, into the later rounds, he's never been past eight rounds. I mean, he's been eight rounds three times, that's it. And of course, Boschiero, as you would expect, 34 years old, fought for a world title, he's been 12 rounds before. Matter of fact, he's been 12 rounds seven times.
And one time on the other end of a split decision for a world title at 130 pounds. They had two 115, 113s, and a 116, 113 in favor of Boschiero, but it went against him with two 115, 113s. Barrios, as you said, skipping 10-round status and going to this 12-round eliminator. Let's check in with the corner, and we'll start with Bernardo.
Thank you, Joe. And in Barrios' corner, Bob Santos said, I want you to use that jab as a stick. Make him pay when he comes in and work the body.
Grisham, what do you got?
At the fighter meetings, Boschiero told us, quote, he was going to attack, attack, attack. But his corner just told him, play it safe, stay safe, and go to the body. Not exactly attack, 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 Joe.
Give a message to him from me, Todd, if you would. Attack, attack, attack. Please. Let's find out what Barrios is all about. The only thing, don't attack if you're Boschiero by reaching in with big punches, because you do that, yeah, then Barrios, with the control of the range like he has right now, will catch you with that kind of left hook. And that's what he's trying to do, I think. Barrios expected, from the tape he watched, Boschiero to come forward more, and maybe a little more recklessly. So you could see Barrios, he's looking to just control range and hope that Boschiero will reach in where he can land a counter, maybe a counter left hook. And he's not getting that. So now Barrios got to change gears a little bit. He's got to press a little bit. I think that's what's going on a little bit. Just, I mean, look at it again. You see Barrios, he expects the control range. He thinks Boschiero's going to come forward where he can drop a counter on him. It's not happening. So Barrios got to make an adjustment.
Here's Bob Santos in the corner.
Okay, that's three in the bank. You got to be busier with the jab, though, okay? You got to be busier with the jab, because every time you use the jab, you're dominating the fight, really dominating it, okay? So be busier with the jab. Stay live in there. Watch what he's doing, okay? Watch what he's doing. Stay busy with the stick. And we got to put some combinations together now, okay? We got to put some combinations together off the jab, all right? You're doing great. Combinations together off the jab, touch him with the body every chance you get. Combinations off the jab, touch him with the body every chance you get. And it's going to pay dividends going down the stretch.
Yeah.
Okay?
Yep.
He's tasting that power. Just use that jab, combinations, touch the body.
Very measured and singular message from his trainer, Bob Santos. Stay busy with that stick and work off of it. Utilize the jab. Everything starts there.
See, that's the change of gears I'm talking about, Joe. I really believe Barrios came in here from watching film that, hey, I'm going to control range. This guy's going to come in with a looping shot from too far away. I'm going to nail him. And it's not happening. So slowly but surely, I think Barrios starting to realize I might have to come forward a little bit, even though I'm the taller guy. And that's exactly what I'm seeing. And let's go back to the fight plan that we did a little while ago. Look at the elbows of Boschiero. They're in right now. Mm-hmm. Now watch, when a punch comes at him, look at it. Look, see how high they go? Look at that opening. That's what I think Barrios can, does the elbows up again. There's nothing protecting that lower body. Now that's protected. Now watch. See, the elbows go out, they go up. When he blocks, leaves the body exposed. That's where I think Barrios should throw a couple throwaway punches. Jab right hand, just to get the arms up, and then finish with the left hook underneath, where there's no elbow. There's those elbows again. They're in now, they're up now.
There's a right hand coming in from Boschiero as he tried to close in on that range.
So I see two opportunities for Barrios to stay undefeated. One is the body work, and the other is just counter opportunities when Boschiero does reach in a little bit with that looping, whether it's a looping right or reaching with a left hook. When he reaches a little bit, there's usually a hole he can fill. The uppercut might not be the worst idea in the world either for the taller Barrios, with his short Boschiero, who sometimes leans a little bit. There's a body, there's the uppercut, but before that, a little look at the body from Barrios. See, nothing here is gonna hurt Boschiero. He's fought for a title already, he's 34 years old. The only one who can really get hurt, at least in my way I look at boxing, is Barrios, a 21-year-old kid who people are talking well about. And if he gets on national TV, which he is right now, and he doesn't look as good as the people have been told he is, that can hurt. So here's a little proof to what I'm talking about, why I'm talking about the body's open in Boschiero. Look at those elbows. There's no protection underneath at all. He goes up high and wide, and he does it again to protect upstairs, leaving downstairs wide open. It's up to Barrios to see what we see and to do something about it.
Younger by 13 years, taller by 8 inches, and unbeaten is Mario Barrios. Teddy's scorecard is going to sit ringside here, clean sweep. Haven't seen much from Boschiero so far. Viewers at home see it the same way.
I'm a little disappointed he hasn't, or somebody hasn't seen with the Barrios camp the opportunity to set up that body work, but more. I'm upset, or a little disappointed, not upset, but disappointed that Barrios, again, with just the physical advantages he has, not using that jab more.
Bernie?
You know, Bob Santos was telling me that what's coming up next is he's going to want Mario Barrios to get into his own fight, fight his fight, and they were kind of watching his punch output. This is the first time he's going 12 rounds. He skipped over 10. So they want to make sure he has gas down the stretch.
Point we talked about earlier, and now it's coming up in the corner of Barrios.
At this pace, he'd have gas to go 30 rounds.
That's right. He could toe the line like they did back in the late 1800s.
Exactly, like the great, my favorite fight of all time, the great Sam Langford.
Yep.
This fight doesn't get more interesting. I'm going to tell you a Sam Langford story.
Please do.
Wait a minute. Again, you see the range controlled by Barrios, but very little else. He keeps his separation. You want separation? You got a shorter guy. But you want to do something with that separation. If the guy's not coming in, then hit him with the jab, keep the separation, set the table, and then eat with the right hand. But he's not doing that. Or you jab and you take a little step back, get the shorter man to reach in, create a little opening, and then you counter. None of that happening right now. And like I said earlier, for Barrios, I know that he's probably surprised Boschiero not coming the way he thought he would, so, all right, change gears. Start creating offense instead of waiting for it on the back end. Use your jab. And look, in all fairness, Barrios is 21 years old and first time under the light, so maybe I should give him a little break.
We'll take a little break right now into five. Devis Boschiero and Mario Barrios. You know, to talk to Barrios earlier this week, he was expecting something out of Boschiero that Todd Grisham, we are yet to see.
Hey, Joe, yeah, funny story. I'm in the corner here of Devis Boom Boom Boschiero, and his cut man leaned over to me earlier and said, listen, I'm buddies with Ray Boom Boom Mancini, who just sent me a text and said, why is this guy calling Boom Boom? He's an embarrassment to the nickname. He doesn't throw enough punches to be a Boom Boom.
Well, I'd like to see a little more boom out of Boschiero.
Well, my question is, what's the cut man doing taking phone calls in the corner? Are you kidding me? What's he doing taking Texas in the corner? And you got a fight going on here.
Boschiero's got a lot of experience both from the amateurs and through his 11-year pro career. Three-time Italian national champion before he went forth towards 39 pro wins and a chance at a title back in 2011. Fought over in Japan, lost a split decision there. And now another opportunity winner of this fight to put themselves in position for a mandatory title bout.
You saw just a second ago a little peek at that other fight plan, but I talked about if Boschiero was to pull off the upset, how could he do it? You know, and that would be get low and then step in with the left hook. He did it a moment ago. It wasn't bad. He needs to do it more often because there's an opportunity for it. If Boschiero will do it and take that chance, get low, step and come in with those left hook as Barrios steps out. Barrios does step out with his chin up. And I noticed with that right hand a little low. But to do that, to pull that off, for Boschiero to pull that off, you have to have the nerve. You have to be willing to believe you can do it and take the chance to do it. Because you're going into the lion's den a little bit. You're trying to catch the lion as he's stepping out. Again, I can see the opportunity for Boschiero to just step with Barrios as he goes out. A little bit like Shavakov did last week against the undefeated at that time, undefeated Harry.
And suffering his first loss in a main event last week on the PBC.
Done! Just keep working off the jab. Keep doing what you're doing off the jab. But bring some of the punches underneath now, okay? Some of the combinations underneath. He's been seeing everything over the top. So now bring some of that stuff underneath, okay? Everything off the jab, but bring some of it underneath. Okay? And let that hook fly every once in a while. We're great.
Take a look right here about what I'm talking about. Boschiero could step in with the left hook. The left hook could be there as Barrios goes out. Problem there, he threw the left hook, but he didn't take the step. Boschiero needs to add the step forward, and then that left hook, instead of just getting a swoosh in the air, might get a pop on the chin of Barrios. And if they don't start doing that soon, I'm gonna tell the Sam Watson story.
Fans enjoy your appreciation for boxing history.
Thank you.
Far more than just a championship level trainer and world-class analyst, but you are truly an elite historian of the game.
Appreciate that. Not quite in the class of the Mike Silvers or the Russell Peltzes out there, but
Mr. Gray. We haven't had a Mr. Gray mentioned in a long time. You see the work tonight. Barrios 60 punches per round. Boschiero 52 total punches in the fight. 34-year-old who came over from Italy last week. Comes from the north of Italy, a town just inland and southwest of Venice. His management team comes from the Milano area. A little bit of a strong dialect difference between many of the Italian Americans we have here at New Jersey compared to where he comes from. But for those of us a little familiar with Italian American slang, you would say his offensive effort tonight is mezzomort, Teddy. A little mezzomort. Yeah, half dead.
How's the sauce? More importantly.
Last night it was molto bene.
Molto bene. See, there you saw a jab in the right hand by Barrios. Great opportunity for him to have slipped his head to his left after that right hand and find the left hook position underneath where that elbow of Boschiero wouldn't be there. You know, you can forgive some things and you hear the booing, and I understand it. You can forgive some things that you're not seeing from Barrios at 21 years of age. Turned pro when he was 18. Here onto the big lights, first time. But what you can't forgive is him or somebody in his corner not getting him to use that jab more. That should be an automatic, the jab. In this instance, with a shorter guy that is standing out there.
Look at the total jab numbers here. CompuBox not having to do much work tonight.
When we come back, we will have more Barrios, Boschiero, and a story about Sam Langford.
Teddy's going to the utility belt for round number 8.
Time! Use your jab, hands high. Start banging him to the body. Pick up the pace a little bit. Yeah. You're doing great. Everything's great. Keep doing what you're doing.
Joe and Teddy ringside here. Round number 8 between Barrios and Boschiero. Teddy, give me hope that there is something that changes course here. It is scheduled for 12 rounds. Could there be anything strategic by Boschiero of patiently waiting for a moment to then accelerate?
Yeah, getting confidence. You know, 34 years old, 4-4 world title. Obviously has been in with a much better opposition than Barrios. Just, again, knowing that there's an opportunity there that he doesn't have Godzilla in front of him. Well, it doesn't appear he has right now. And just getting, you know, the motor running. Just starting to realize, hey, I'm 34 years old, but I've been places this kid hasn't been. You know what? Let me find out what this kid has. He hasn't shown me a lot for the first 7. So let me start doing something. I was a little worried to do it early, but let me be less worried. That's what you hope for. You know, if you want to see Boschiero start doing more.
5'5", Devis Boschiero. You were mentioning Sam Langford. Sam Langford wasn't a tall guy. Sam Langford was only a couple of inches taller than Boschiero.
Yeah,
and he fought in every weight class that was known to man because he had power that carried. What did you want to tell us about Langford?
Well, he was a monster. My favorite fighter of all time back in the 1920s. And there's a little stepping in. I'll wait a minute now, maybe.
See, just by invoking his name,
oh, you're scared.
It brought about some action.
Yeah, you got him revved up a little hearing about the great Sam Langford. He'll do it. He will do that. But more importantly, you saw the opportunity for Boschiero to step with Barrios and nail him as Barrios goes out, straight line, and the hands low, the chin high. If Boschiero doesn't keep it up, we'll get to Sam Langford the next round.
PBC main event. Let's show you the schedule coming up as Premier Boxing Champion spreads across all the networks in this month of July. You see the second fight listed there. Deontay Wilder, heavyweight titleist at 36-0. Be facing the former two-time title challenger. Familiar face for us, Chris Areola. That fight down home for Wilder in Birmingham, Alabama. What do you see there?
At this point, Areola, what, 35 years old, right? I believe. I mean, he's been in so many tough fights. I love Chris Areola. You know, he's a fighter through and through, game guy. But he's a guy that's absorbed a lot over the years. And at this point in his career, I don't know that he can absorb the power from Wilder. Wilder does a lot of things wrong. But one thing he does right, he can punch like a son of a gun with that right hand. And one of the things that at this point in his career that Ariel does wrong and has done wrong, unfortunately, for a while, is he gets caught with right hands.
Oh, yeah. He will take him. And he will come forward and give.
He's got all the heart in the world. That's why I love him. But again, at 35, I believe he's 35, at 35 years of age, and all the punishment that he's taken, it's going to be a tough hill to climb against Wilder. Although Wilder gives you plenty of chances, pull him back straight, hands down. You know, he'll give you plenty of chances to catch him. But before you can catch him, you got to get close. You got to get past that long jab. You got to avoid that really dangerous right hand.
In the case of Boschiero against Barrios, you have to throw punches to land punches, and he has only thrown 78, only landing 15. Barrios only landing 41, 8% landed.
Boschiero has
copy been box steady, 56 combined total punches landed. We're in the ninth round.
You know, this is going to be interesting, what I'm going to say in a funny way. Boschiero has been cut by head clashes, but you're not going to see a head clash tonight. If we saw a head clash, we'd have a better chance that it's going to be the kind of fight Boschiero needs if he's going to have a chance to pull
That's
off
exactly
an upset.
Right.
Because that means he's coming forward.
They're not close enough
exactly
to have a head clash.
There's
he's not putting himself in a position to have a head clash.
Exactly, Joe.
Well, I'll remind you that SportsCenter will be coming up as soon as we are finished here in Trenton, New Jersey, with this PBC main event. We'll have the day of action. Hear from Serena Williams after Miss Williams is the Wimbledon champion once again.
Again, I think the most disappointing thing about Barrios, besides, you know, the fact he didn't use the jab, but just that he didn't do more. That there's opportunities, and I know you got to mature, you got to find your way. You know, you got to grow a little bit your first time, potentially going 12 rounds. you know, you have to get that confidence. I understand all that, and you're going through that period of growth, mentally and emotionally. But still, in this fight, there's opportunities to do more. You have to recognize that.
Coming to the nine.
Well, take a look here. Barrios finally lands the body shot. The elbows come out, as we've been talking about. The elbows of Boschiero. He goes to block. Wide open downstairs. Barrios lands a good right hand underneath. Problem with that, Joe, is that was the only one he threw.
Barrios, the 21-year-old from San Antonio, Texas. He loves telling the story of his mom starting him off in boxing, and his older sister Selena is very successful.
For you great, great loyal fans that have stayed with us, here's a payoff. Sam Langford.
Here we go.
Now, Sam Langford fought during the golden era of boxing back in the 1920s when he had so many great fighters, and they went a lot of rounds. Sometimes they got 40, even more than 40 rounds in a fight. And look, it's a legendary story. I love the story. Who knows about exactly how accurate it is, but I don't care. He was fighting a fighter, and they're going out with great Sam Langford. Now, he had 300 fights. Is that amazing?
That's ridiculous.
And I think about 110 knockouts. I mean, that's ridiculous, too. He had all these fights as the great Sam Langford. He fought from lightweight to heavyweight, beat 9 future Hall of Fame champions. Nobody would fight him for the title. So he's going in there, they're walking out to the ring. And as they're walking out to the ring in those days, they would literally bring their lunch. Because you're going 40 rounds, Joe, you're going 50 rounds, whatever. So you bring sometimes a case of oranges to eat while you're out there to sustain yourself. So they're going out there, Langford's going out there, the other guy's going out there with his case of oranges. All of a sudden, the other guy looks at the great Sam Langford. You know, he's already a little intimidated. He's already nervous. It's Sam Langford. And he looks over and he says, Sam, you miscounted. You only got 5. Sam only had 5 oranges he was carrying. He said, Sam Langford looks at him and said, only gonna need 5. Knocked him out in the 5th round.
I love it. And a lot of historians consider Langford to be a guy who was denied even more greatness than he should have had because of how things went back then.
Yeah.
Lack of opportunity for a guy like him.
Yeah, I mean, more to the point, of lack of opportunity, our country hadn't grown the way it's grown now. Unfortunately, a lack of opportunity for a black fighter, that he wouldn't get the chances that he deserved to get, that a white fighter would get and did get. And he didn't get that opportunity to fight for the title because of that, and that's a shame, but not for me. He's still great.
You know, when you preview a fight like this, Teddy, when you look at the records, you realize the difference in experience, in age, of one guy on the way up with a lot of promise, another guy who has already established himself and had opportunities. You hope to always at least get this. Can the young prospect pass a test? I don't know that a test has been taken tonight to even pass.
Yeah, that's a real good point, actually. A test hasn't been given.
That's correct. One hasn't been administered.
That's a very good point. And you still have to be left wondering. Because you would have wanted to see, again, I'm trying not to be too critical here, he's winning every round on my scorecard, but you wanted to see him do more. I can't put it more simply than that. I understand the doubts, the bright lights, the doubts of being in his position. Supposed to go 12 rounds first time. I understand all that, but the real good ones, they swallow that. They take that, they put it to the side. They see the opportunity as the fight, you know, transpires. And they change gears, they hit the gas, and they show you why there's somebody you want to follow. Why they're undefeated. Why some people think they're going to be good or better than good.
Bernardo, give me a sense of what you're gathering in Barrios' corner.
It's been repetitive. Throw the jab, combinations, let your hands go. I want to see the uppercut. The one thing is that there's no sense of urgency, and you see that reflected in the fighter.
And Todd Grisham with Boschiero's group.
Joe, you grew up in an Italian household.
See.
Italians are very vocal. They're emotional. They talk with their hands. They're passionate. The corner over here in Boschiero's corner, it's like an Italian library. There's nothing. It's dead silence. It's like The Godfather. There's a scene where no one's talking. Everyone's nervous. There's no emotion at all.
And reflective of what we've seen inside the ropes as well, Todd.
Well, maybe someone should tell Boschiero that the Italian to have a conversation in the ring in the Italian way, where you move your hands a lot as you're having that conversation. Maybe that would produce punches or hand movement.
It was actually more dangerous to be on the dance floor at your son's wedding last night than to be in the center of this ring.
Actually, someone tore their ACL.
What?
Yeah, they did. They tore their ACL on the dance floor. I can't believe you brought that up. Yes. Yeah, one of my son's great, beautiful buddies.
He's a wonderful guy.
Wonderful, beautiful
He walked
guy.
To the barbecue today
yeah,
with a can
in,
of post.
He came in with crutches.
ACL on the dance floor.
Yeah,
we've seen it all.
We have. Give me those crutches, will you?
Se Movico tocca mandare a volo col primo colpo, bisogna andare dentro. Dai, crede che offerti. Più nervoso, rabbioso. Rabbioso, Davis.
Last round, touch gloves in the middle.
Clean everything up with your hook. You got a great hook, use it. But be smart, all right? Last round, he's going to go for broke, okay? He knows he's desperate, so he's probably going to open up a little bit, okay? Use your jab, combinations, you can counter them. And clean everything up with that hook.
Sure.
All right, he's gonna come for it right now. Let's close the show on him. Let's close the show on him. You look great.
Okay, last round, guys. Looking good.
Charlton Bucks. Time around here of our main event. Boschiero and Barrios. Sometimes they see the light at the end of the tunnel, able to extend themselves. Let's hope for that.
Well, part of the problem was that Barrios was worried about pacing himself. That should not show itself here because he's in the last round, doesn't have to worry about pacing himself. It's over after this round, and he's still fresh, obviously. You can see he's in no way fatigued. So if it was a mental problem, and look, I could buy that. Maybe it was a mental problem, worried about pacing himself. But then he should be more aggressive this round, and he has moved his hands a little more.
I put that right hand to the body.
See, there's those elbows going up again. Every time Barrios throws a jab at Boschiero, the elbows, look at those elbows, how high they go.
Watch behind the head.
But again, Barrios not dropping anything, not going to the basement, not putting water in that basement of Boschiero's. I didn't see it, may have been a
four.
Six, seven, eight.
Step to me. Okay, step to me now. Stop. Stay there. Come to me. Okay, good. Go.
I think they're saying that his right knee touched the canvas in exchange. So see a knockdown.
Yeah, I think that we're going to see on the replay that Barrios finally did throw that counter when Boschiero reached in and caught him on the way in.
And now action to close out this 12th and final round. There's a right hand from Boschiero.
Yeah, you see the opportunities now we talked about all night. They're finally coming to fruition where Boschiero can catch Barrios going back. Barrios can catch him coming in.
Wouldn't you have loved to have seen that throughout the night? When possible, they engaged. A knockdown was scored in that 12th round.
Yeah, watch the left uppercut, I think. Right there, left uppercut as he's coming in. That's what nailed him, that left hand of Barrios. Watch right here, maybe a better angle. And there it is.
Left uppercut as he throws the right hand. And that little
exactly.
bit of a delayed reaction, though.
Yeah, again, he's exposing himself, Boschiero, pulling away that right hand. And as he opens up with that, as you said, Joe, that wide right hand, giving up defense for offense, Barrios nails him on the way in with the left uppercut. In other words, again, an opening created by the white punch and a chance for Barrios to fill the spot.
So finally some action here in our main event, and it comes late. A reminder, next week we will be in Tunica, Mississippi. It's going to be a 9 Eastern start time for the PBC on ESPN, and Sergey Lipinets is unbeaten at 9-0 with 7 knockouts. He will take on the veteran Walter Castillo. Lipinets Castillo, another fight of a unbeaten prospect against a weathered veteran. That is next week, the PBC on ESPN. Knockdown scored in the 12th and final round caps an easy evening for the undefeated Mario Barrios. And the Facebook scoring a clean sweep as well. For the judges' scores, we go to Ray Flores.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 12 rounds, we go to the scorecards. All three judges, Kasen Cheeks, Eugene Grant, and Joe Pasquale, have the bout identical, 120-107. For your winner by unanimous decision, Mario El Niño de Oro Barrios.
Very active young fighter is Mario Barrios. The 21-year-old now goes to 16-0 with the unanimous decision victory.